Hello and welcome back to another Space Engineers Showcase video. In today's video, we're looking at another long-distance hauling ship, which is called the Voyager Contract Hauler, which is this lovely thing right here. Now, this ship is purposely designed to do those exceptionally long-distance hauling contracts that you can do thanks to the economy update. It can jump just over 10,000 kilometers in a single blind jump. It's got plenty of defense on it, it's got a large cargo container for you to store the goods in, and it's got a nice big interior for you to live your life in. So if you press F10 and find it in the spawn menu, there it is. This lovely ship is 1,644 large blocks. It requires the Decorative Block 2 DLC pack and the Decorative Block 1 DLC pack, and they are very much required for the interior design. So we're gonna start by taking a look around the outside, and then we'll go and drive it around, do a little blind jump, and that'll be it. Also, if you are interested in the skybox, there will be a link to it in the description below, just below the link for this ship. So coming around to the front, we have got an industrial cockpit, which is how we're going to fly this ship. Now you can, if you want to, and was stated on the Steam Workshop page, if you don't want to use a cockpit, you can just remove that, put in a window block, and simply put a flight seat behind it. The developer has deliberately left room behind the seat for you to do that, which is very nice to have that option. So we've got two window blocks next to it, or the ones that could be used as stairs, and then two proper window blocks. Then as we move all the way down, we got ourselves a camera to view directly forwards, and aim those two rocket launchers. Below them, we got ourselves some spotlights so we can always light up the darkness, which come down to some ramps, down some stairs, and down to an antenna right here. We do have an ore detector on this, so you can go and get resources yourself. Just fly close to an asteroid and see what goodies it has inside it. Below that, we got some ion thrusters. Now, ion and hydrogen thrusters are the only ones that appear on this ship. How well does it fly in an atmosphere? Well, we'll find out later in this video. But as for space, it's bloody perfect. So we've got a bunch of large ion thrusters, some small ones, and then we have an interior pillar on an unfinished interior pillar with a little light on the end. As we move around the base, we've got some windows, another antenna. And as we just come up and above here, we can see our DLC window where we can view inside at our large cargo container, which is going to store all our goodies, and then we have a small LCD screen which is going to tell you your faction if you're a part of one. As we move up, we've got an interior wall with a gyroscope on it and a Gatling turret just above there for a little bit of defense. Moving on up to the top, we've got an interior turret with a doorway and an orange catwalk which is going to be our main way in and out of our bridge. If we just come around over to here, we've got some more thrusters along the top and some more over there. If I just come around to the back of this ship, we've got some more ion thrusters, and here are our hydrogen. The hydrogen can be turned off while in space. It's perfectly capable of just having them turned off if you don't want to burn through all your ice. Moving all the way down to here, we've got ourselves some more turrets. We can see some batteries over there with some interior turrets on them, and another little camera. Coming over to this bit right here, we've got a connector for a small ship to dock up to with two little doors, which is going to be our alternative way of getting into the ship. These two doors will lead us into the more manufacturing area of the ship, where we can go directly to our large cargo container. And then moving on all the way down, we've got a few more iron thrusters to help push us along through space. Underneath here, we do have a couple hydrogen tanks and a spotlight to shine up down below here to make sure you always know who's going to land on that pad. And we can see sneakily inside here the first of many jump drives on this ship. They're quite sneakily hidden around there, so once you think you've found them all, you'll find a few more. As we come all the way up round to the top, we do have a window there that isn't a doorway. That is in fact our sleeping quarters. Just looks a bit odd thanks to those windows textures. All the way up onto the top, guess what? Jump drives with some orange stripes going across with some windows and some interior turrets just to protect them. Moving along to the back, we have our remote control. Down and underneath, there's not too much really to talk about underneath here. There's just a connector and a merge block, which is how we're going to connect up to our station and load up our cargo container or unload it, depending on what you want to do. And that just about covers the outside of the Voyager contract hauler. So now it's time to go inside it. Yeah, so getting into my character, we've got a few ways where we can go. I think I will come all the way down to the back of the ship, down to here. So dropping down here, we do have a gravity generator in the ship, so we don't float away when we jump. We can just walk up to here, just look around a bit at the spotlight up there, those hydrogen thrusters and the blinking lights on it. Just come through the door, close it up. And we have a little locker where we can just unload our tools if we don't need it and just walk around, and there is our cargo container. We can climb up this ladder, which then take us further up into the ship. So there we go. And this is our access point for the cargo container, where we can just dump all our stuff in here, dump our resources in here, and away we go. We can view out this lovely little window at the asteroid over there. Opening up this door and coming through, we don't have to worry about closing it because they have been scripted. So up this ladder, we go even further up to the ship. Now this is going to take us to our main living quarter and our bridge, which is why it is so long. I should have used my jetpack for this, but I'm sure I can keep talking. So we're going to come up this ladder through this little passageway, and this is our main area. We've got our DLC projected table with a table in front of it. We've got screens galore. We've got a bunch of chairs, lights, survival kits, and catwalks going all the way along. We can see a jump drive up there, which, surprise, surprise, you're going to see even more of them later. Yes, we have a programmable block over here, which we can edit and see our automatic LCD script on there. Well, on this one, we can see our jump drives, whether they're charged or not. We've got some control seats that have nothing on them, but if you wanted to, you could set up controls for the turrets. Over here, we've got another LCD screen, which is telling you everything about your power, your hydrogen tanks, your batteries and your small reactors, O2H2 generators and all that. Survival kit to respawn on, which is always handy to have. And behind here, we've got some more lockers to store your goodies in. Now this bit over here will lead us down to the opposite side of where we just were over there. But now where do we go? Because we can go up here into our cockpit, which is quite nice. I do like being able to just walk into the back of the cockpit just to get access to it. Yes, we've got some oxygen tanks around here, plenty of windows. Got a little living quarters over here where we can just sit on here, have a bit of relaxation while staring at this planter. We got some button panels over here which are going to be for the lights to turn them on and off. We can look out the window, and we got a locker and a cargo access over here. Over on this side, we got our vending machine, and we can view inside there at part of the jump drive. And around here, another locker. We have a doorway over here, which is a double door for an airlock, so that'll have to close up, and that will automatically open. And there we are, we're now on the outside. Coming back in, closing up, and it'll automatically open this door, then close it. Lovely stuff. We can go to the opposite side. So over this lovely catwalk block, which I really do like, I love this block from the new DLC pack. We come to our laboratory area, where we've got our decorative block over there, a table, button panels for the lights, another doorway to lead outside, lockers, cargo access, and some more lockers on this side. So we can just walk around, come down to here, then we'll go through the back of the ship. It's surprising how big this ship actually is when you look at it from the outside and then you get on the inside. It's some kind of TARDIS effect. So we go over to here. This is our kitchen area where we can sit here, eat your food, have your cook prepare it in front of you, and above us, yes, a jump drive. Walking around over to here and through this door, this is the area we saw earlier, our sleeping area where we can go to sleep, come back out, have a nice view outside at that turret down there and see what it's shooting. Then we can just walk through here and to the opposite side. On the opposite side, we've got like a little medical bay and a toilet. We can just go in the toilet, get in the cryopod if you needed to, and a small MRI machine if you really needed to do that. Coming back through and all the way around, we can now go through two ways. We can go down or through this door. So, waiting for that door to close up, then I'll open up this one again. Uh-oh. Let me just go and... Uh-oh. No, please open. There we go. I should be able to squeeze through there. There we are. We can now just come through this door right here and access the O2H2 generator if you wanted to manually put stuff in. We've got our large hydrogen tanks surrounding us and another jump drive above us. Now coming through this door and pretending like I didn't just break it, let's just go like that. There we go, I'm sure that's fine. We can come down this ladder right here. So dropping down here, we're coming to almost like the secret heart of the ship, where we've got our gravity generator and a bunch of programmable blocks. We got simple doors, which is a nice thing. In fact, what is the simple doors? I don't remember that one. Ah, I see. The script will automatically close the door 1 second after being opened, which is lovely. Very nice script. I might steal that script for my own use. Then on this one, what do we have? An empty programmable block over here. Another empty one. And then over here, we then got another empty one. And that's our gravity generator. Behind there, we can see a large reactor, which is going to be powering this ship along. In fact, let's start tearing this down. So through here, let's remove some of these blocks. What do we have around here? So this is our large reactor that sits on top of our cargo container. And there's nothing too much else going on in this little room. Coming all the way back through, past our air vent, which is a nice way of hiding it, all the way up to top, it's time to now drive it. I believe I have covered all the little rooms in this ship. Let's just close that up and go all the way around. So coming all the way to the cockpit, it's time to fly this ship. So we've got plenty of options to do, and I am in survival mode just to check this out. So we don't have unlimited ammo, but we do have those two rockets at the front there where we can just waste it all up. Number two and number three are for the camera at the front and the camera at the back. Number four and number five is for our ion and hydrogen thrusters. So this is it flying around without the hydrogen, and then we can switch on the hydrogen, which is quite nice. So just have them both on, we get a nice speedy ship. Number six is for our jump drive, and we can jump 11,623.95 kilometers, which is a bloody long way to go. Number seven and number eight are to turn the spotlights at the front and down there on and off, an antenna on and off. We've got controls for the connectors all the way around the ship, and then we got some controls over the distance of the jump drive. Number seven is for our Gatling turrets on and off. Number eight is for our ore detector on and off. And number nine is for our interior turrets on and off. On tab number three, we got controls for all the way around the ship. So number one, we can press that and it will toggle the doors on and off. It just instantly flicks back as soon as you press it. I'm not too sure what it's for, so I'm just going to ignore it. Number two is for our beacon on and off. Number three is for our hydrogen tank on and off. Number four is to put our batteries into auto or recharge. Number five is for our merge block on and off. Six, seven, eight are for our lights. And number nine is for the LCD screens. Tab number four, we got controls for even more lights, so we can turn them all on and off if you wanted to do that. And that just about covers what this ship can do. So now it's going to be time to fly it around. So going forwards, we got one hell of a lot of speed, and we can go bloody fast with this. Stopping is a little bit slow, but nothing you can't solve by doing a 180 and boosting all the way forwards. Going left and going right is quite slow. Going down and going up is once again quite slow. So going forwards is going to be great for boosting away from those pirates while getting your jump drives recharged. Speaking of jump drives, let's go and jump somewhere over into this direction right here. So we're right next to the Earth-like planet, pressing number six. Let's go and do a big old jump and see where we go. So six, five, four, three, two, one. Game, don't crash. There we go. And where is the planet behind us? We have left it behind. We just about see it over there. I don't know why I just pointed with my finger, because you can't see my finger, but you should be able to see it right behind me. So that was a great distance away. Next test will be to see if it can fly in a atmosphere. So we're going to do this by using the spawn commands. Oop, the free camera is back where I left it, so let's just go over to here and find where that is right there. Let's just spin this around. Find our spawn menu. I think it was this button right here. Hopefully I don't turn off shadow play. Earth-like planet. Let's make it like that and bring it over to us like so. So we just spawn that in. In control of my character. Finding the seat. And here we go. So we're now in an atmosphere. And we're going down. Unfortunately, it looks like He cannot do it. Well, actually, changing my mind about that, we can just about fly as long as we tilt backwards and use our main thrusters. But yes, we can just about fly on a planet. But other than that, it's a fantastic idea for doing the long haul contracts from one of the outposts. And it's nice and easy to build if you just want to project to this and use it rather than build something yourself. So it'll be in the description below. If you wish to download and play around with it yourself, I highly recommend you do. Because it's a fantastic little design and can jump a bloody long distance. So yes, thank you all for watching, and I'll be back with another video some point soon. Bye bye.